Russell Square is once quite a notable gay cruising spot, and they took out a lot of the bushes and the undergrowth, and there was a campaign to have them retained for that reason, to provide cover for kind of nighttime trysts. These are great. These are the cabbies' tea huts. There are not many of them left in London now. Lovely bit of detail there, just below the roof line. The cabmen's shelters. First presented in 1901. It's doing all right for a shed, isn't it? Over 100 years old. Sheep, tea and coffee. Kate's Tea Food Hut. 80p for a cup of tea. £1 for a coffee. Cappuccino, £1.50. You cannot argue with that. £2.20 for a bacon roll. Lovely little bit of sort of art deco-ish detail here on the gateposts at the School of Oriental and African Studies, SOAS. I think this is the Institute of Education. I think it's a noted brutalist building. Something quite wonderful about it, isn't there? The statue is called the Green Man. It's in Woburn Square. It's a really beautiful little square, Woburn Square. Look at this delightful little shelter. Peaceful of Bloomsbury Squares. More blossom on this tree here, more signs of spring. It's still deepest, darkest winter. Tavistock Square, one of the most special Bloomsbury squares. There's a real theme of peace running through the monuments here. That's the tree planted in commemoration of the victims of Hiroshima. This is a monument to pacifism. Inscription reads to all those who have established and are maintaining the right to refuse to kill. So I suppose it's additionally poignant that it was at Tavistock Square that one of the bombs went off on the 7th of July 2005, the 7/7 bombings, when a bus was blown up here on one side of the square. That's the thing with peace. You have to maintain it, even in the face of violence.
I would say you have to maintain it, especially in the face of violence. After tonight, come and see me old mate Gandhi. There he is. I went to see his house in Mumbai. It took us ages to find it. And it's a very grand residence. When he was there spinning his cloth, he was doing it, living in quite some style. But, doubtless a great man. Very timeless message. So that house over there was once home to Vladimir Ilyich Lenin. He also lived up on Holford Square, not far from here, just near King's Cross in Pentonville. This is where the Russian Revolution was plotted, in these streets around here, between here and King's Cross and up to Islington.